मूकं करोति वाचालं पंगुं लंघयते गिरिं यत्कृपातमहं वंदे परमानंदमाधवं परमानंदमाधवं। இந்த பகவத்கீதா பகவான் ஸ்ரீ கிருஷ்ணா ஸ்பீக்ஸ் ஆஃப் த்ரீ கைண்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் விஷன். த ஃபஸ்ட் விஷன் ஹி கால்ஸ் இட் அஸ் அ ஆல் இன்க்ளூசிவ் விஷன். த செகண்ட் விஷன் ஹி கால்ஸ் இட் அஸ் அ விஷன் ஆஃப் டைவர்சிட்டி. And the third one, he says, is a narrow-minded vision or the fanatical vision. Let me just quote the verses and then we will see for ourselves what he means by these. Sarva bhuteshu yenaikam bhavam avyayam ikshate avibhaktam vibhakteshu tadjnanam viddhi sattvikam. Sarva bhuteshu, all beings, sarvabhuteshu, all beings are different, their nature is different, their characteristics are different, the way they live are different, their thoughts are different, they're structurally different, culturally different. Differences are seen, but if a person is able to transcend these differences and see something which is unique, common, same, in all, such a vision which sees that unity in spite of the differences. The eyes, the ears, the nose, the tongue, the skin will only give us differences. Their function is to show the differences. But it is the intelligence behind which is able to understand that these differences are only superficial, but the inside core is one and the same. If a mind can comprehend this, this, he says, is the vision of all inclusiveness, and he terms this as the highest vision. The term given is sattvika vision, sattvika jnana. Then going to the rajasic vision or the vision of diversity, he explains, prataktvena tu yad jnanam nana bhavan pratak vidhan vetti sarveshu bhuteshu tadjnanam with the rajasam. Pratakvena tu yajnanam, that knowledge which comprehends differences and gives validity to the differences, refuses to go beyond differences, just is entrapped within differences, such a knowledge, such a vision, such a thinking, he calls it as a rajasic vision or the rajasic thinking. The most interesting one is the tamasic vision. He says, Yattu Krishnavad Ekasmin, Ekasmin in one thing, making it as the whole. A small thing is there, but making a mountain out of the molehill, as they say. And keeping that to be the truth. And that truth, that it is, that is the ultimate thing, that is the final vision, that is not logically arrived at, he says, Yattu Krishnavad Ekasmin Karye Saktam Ahaitukam. There's no logic, there's no reasoning. So if somebody takes a stand and lives one's life based on such a wrong stand, 50 years, 40 years back, we had such a person, I think Talwarji had also shown, there was a person who decided that one community, one section of people, are parasites of the society. And he said that they all should be exterminated. And 4 million people were destroyed in a period of 3 months. Amazing achievement. I don't think anybody can easily do that. 4 million people, kill them in 3 months. How? Ahaitukam. No logic, no reasoning. Yattu Krishnavad Ekasmin Karye Saktam Ahaitukam Atatvartavad Alpartam cha, atatvartavat, it is not valid. Alpam, a very limited vision, tat tamasam udahrutam. And this is a narrow-minded vision or the fanatical vision. And this is a tamasic vision. So you have the sattvic vision of all-inclusiveness, the rajasic vision of giving validity to diversity and staying stuck there, and the tamasic vision which takes one thing and blows it out of proportion. So these three vision, in these three vision, if you see, much of the problem in the world arises because of tamasic vision. Really speaking, it is a rajasic vision which progresses into tamasic vision. And the solution to all these things is a sattvic vision by which we ignore, I would say rather than ignore, we sublate the divisiveness. By seeing something which is common, but by seeing something that which unites all. In one more place there's an example given. It says, Sutre Maniganaiva. Mani means the beads. The beads could be different. But hidden amongst the beads, tying all of them together, making them into a garland, is that thread of unity. When the thread of unity is caught, the diversity is beautiful. Because when we see the diversity, we see the beauty. But that is there only when we see the unity. If we lack the unity and see the diversity, it will only progress into vision of divisiveness and vision of narrow-mindedness. So if this conference can light up the flame of the vision of unity, I think much of it will be served. There's a very beautiful ancient verse. Unity is such a core to the Indian thinking, the Indian ethos and the Indian habit. It's a very beautiful verse. I'm sure many of you may also have heard it. Swami Vivekananda quoted that in his talk in the Parliament of Religions. Trayi Sankhyam Yogaha Pashupati Matam Vaishnavamiti Prabhinne Prasthane Paramidamada Patyamiti Cha Ruchinam Vaichitriya. Beautiful word. Ruchinam Vaichitriya. Taste differs. Ruchinam Vaichitriya. Rujukutila Nana Patachusha. Rename Ko Gamyaha. Tomasi Payasam Arunavamiva. At that time, the various religions that inhabited the minds of people. Trayi, the Vedic religion, Sankhyaha, Sankhyam, Pashupati, Yogaha, Pashupati Matam is Shaivism. So Vedas, the Vedic religion, then the Sankhya, the Yoga, the Shaiva, the Vaishnava, the various religions, Pribhinne Prasthani, each one holding different realms, and people discussing among themselves, this is higher, this is better. And all these discussions, says the author, Ruchinam Vaichitriyat is only because of the taste and nothing more. Each one differ and therefore each one's preferences also differ. Why make a issue of that? Even if we go to the dining hall and you have chapati and you have rice, you have 2-3 vegetables, everybody chooses a different thing because that suits them. But remember, all of them give nourishment to the body. Ruchinam Vaichitriyat Rujukutila Pata Nana Patajusham, different parts going in different directions. But ultimately, just as how all the rivers go to one ocean, so too all these religions, in whatever way they travel, they have one ultimate, one goal, the absolute, the ultimate, the unconditioned. If you take all religions and if you see what is the name for God, all the names say it is unconditioned, unlimited, unnameable, beyond human comprehension. How can such a one which is beyond human comprehension, unlimited, when we say unlimited, infinite, you cannot have many, many, many of that. Brahman, Allah. In some traditions they have the name which is not to be pronounced. Because that is the worship and the glory they pay to the ultimate reality. If that reality is infinite, how can you have many infinite? It has to be one. Nrinam eko gamyaha. all beings go to that one same reality, albeit through different paths. There's a very beautiful instance, anecdote, in Mahatma Gandhiji's life. In Mahatma Gandhiji's ashrama, Sabarmati ashrama, early morning, 4 o'clock, 4:30, there used to be prayer. And then the day would start. So in that prayer, there used to be like how we had today morning, there used to be the Bible recitation, the Quran recitation, followed by the Gita and the Guru Granth Sahib, and so on. So one, these newspaper reporters are very dangerous people. So one reporter, he caught Mahatma Gandhiji and he asked him a query, a very tough query to a person like Mahatma Gandhi, who is guiding the whole nation to freedom. So he asked a question. In your ashram, you chant the Gita, you recite the Bible, there are verses from Quran, the Guru Granth Sahib is there. Now tell me which one you like the most. It's a very, very tricky question. And I think it takes purity and genuinity to answer it truthfully. Mahatma Gandhi said, he replied with a question again to that reporter, you have a mother, I have a mother, she has a mother, he has a mother. Which mother do I like? And Gandhiji said, he was stunned when Gandhiji asked the question, which mother you like? Gandhiji came to his assistant, said, look, all of us have our mothers, but I love my mother. And then he continued to say, the very fact I love my mother very deeply, with enormous devotion and great commitment, because of the loving service that she has rendered to me throughout my life, I understand how much you love your mother. In the depth of my love for my mother, I recognize the glory of your devotion for your mother. A one who doesn't love his mother cannot understand how much other person loves his mother also, her mother also, is it not? And then he says, remember, this understanding, this appreciation of how everybody loves their mother, because the depth of understanding how I love my mother is an all-inclusive vision. If this we can bring about, if somehow we understand what is there beautiful in every tradition, in every culture, then there is a purpose and meaning served in a conference like this. Otherwise, it would be just an academic pursuit, paper presented, and one person going and congratulating the other. You did a very lovely presentation. Now you say, you wait, I'm also giving a presentation. But if we can think, what is the beauty in other tradition? And in the same way and the same time, be grounded in our tradition too. That brings about an all-inclusive vision. May this conference bring about a death knell to all religious bigotry, to all fanaticism, to all narrow-mindedness. And wonder of wonder, our conference starts on a Children's Day. Today is November 14. In India, we celebrate the Children's Day, the Children's Day. It's very interesting how it happened that way. May the knowledge what we shine make at least a next generation a happy generation. We have seen too many of fights and arguments based on unnecessary matters, when the truth remains one and the paths remain only many. May we all unite together in our hearts and pay our reverent obeisance to that ultimate reality who transcends all limited thinking and all our petty, paltry emotions and thoughts. I warmly congratulate. Till now I was congratulated, but I think the actual congratulation goes to Professor Jasser. He was a person who said, who mooted this idea and who stood firm behind all of us saying, Swamiji, let's do it. And to the Spiritual Heritage Education Network, who are committed to such a thought, and to all the people here who have come from so many countries and states of the land, I wish everybody all the best. May the Lord's grace and blessings be with us in our noble endeavor. Thank you very much. Hari Om.